March, the month where the sun melts away the winter frost and where millions celebrate their Irish heritage. Most important of all, March Madness. This yearly NCAA tournament usually sends fans to the stands, college students to the beer aisle, and 68 teams to battle it out for the title.
This season, Gonzaga has had a stellar win record. However, it always hasn't been successful in its basketball career. The men's team started their first season way back in 1907 with no coach to lead it. Gonzaga wasn't even noteworthy till they won the WCC tournament in 1995, and Dan Monson coached the team from 1997 to 1999, and in a way helped start Gonzaga's basketball prestige. In 98, he led the Bulldogs to a record-breaking season, achieving greater heights than predicted by analysts and coaches alike. This Cinderella streak brought them to the Elite Eight for the first time. When Monson left in 99, Mark Few was promoted to head coach. He is instrumental in continuing Gonzaga's consecutive streak of NCAA tournament appearances. Under Few, the men's team has garnered 614 wins with 124 losses. His success has given him numerous awards, including 6 consecutive WCC Coach of the Year awards from 2001 to 2006. The team itself has an all-time record of 1,736 wins and 1,117 losses. The Bulldogs have 23 appearances, of which 12 in the Sweet 16, 5 in the Elite 8, 2 in the Final 4, and 1 in the Championship. Some notable Gonzaga players include John Stockton, Rui Hachimura, Adam Morrison, Zach Collins, and Domantas Sabonis. Few teams rival Gonzaga's skill. In what can hardly be called an even rivalry, St. Mary's College has lost 77 games to Gonzaga while winning a measly 33. BYU, one of the few teams that has won multiple games at the McCarthy Center, holds out with 7 wins against Gonzaga with a substantial 20 losses to Gonzaga. Needless to say, our rivals aren't built to handle the Bulldogs. The women's team had its start in 1987 and has since made 12 appearances in the NCAA, of which 4 in the Sweet 16 and 1 in the Elite 8. Former Gonzaga player Courtney Vandersloot was named WNBA All-Star in 2019. Currently, 28 former Gonzaga women's players play professionally. Unfortunately, this is all I could really find on the women's team. Nothing to be found on their all-time win-loss record either. The lack of information is perhaps reflective of the favoritism of men's sports over women's sports. It's not hard to point out the sexism presented in men's versus women's sports. Just this year, there was a stark difference between the workout facilities shown here by Sedona Prince during March Madness.
Gonzaga's teams would not be anything without their fans. They have braved sub-freezing temperatures and long lines just to cheer on the players. Shoot, Gonzaga students are even willing to break COVID regulations and en masse with approximately 400 students to celebrate an Elite Eight win. Here you can see our brilliant students, without masks, take pictures with some of Spokane's finest, who are recently ranked as the third deadliest police department in the United States. I find it exceptionally surprising if Gonzaga's administration were to hold any of these students accountable for their unacceptable actions. If these students were of a different demographic, a less privileged demographic, the outcomes would have been far different.
Behind March Madness is a far more sinister evil, one that cares more about the money than anything else. The evil behind it all is the NCAA. The NCAA doesn't care one bit about the players. Originally, it was created by Theodore Roosevelt to protect student athletes, but this noble and just cause has long since been forgotten. In 2011, Derek Sheely suffered a traumatic brain injury during football practice and died 1 week later. Considered a wrongful death, Sheely repeatedly attempted to get treatment for his injury sustained during an unsafe drill, but was berated by his assistant coach and told to get back on the field. His parents filed a lawsuit 2 years later, which the NCAA took to court, denying that they had any legal duty to protect student athletes. This wasn't the only occurrence of the NCAA dodging responsibility. Following a lawsuit on the behalf of 3 student athletes who claimed the organization failed to protect students from sexual abuse, a lengthy legal review released in 2002 documented that athlete abuse is a serious issue in collegiate sports. Sadly, little has changed since then. Following scandals of abuse and death, the NCAA seldom initiates investigations to hold those responsible. The only time the NCAA punishes anyone under its domain is for breaches in amateurism regulation. The NCAA recently suspended 13 North Carolina football players for selling their shoes given to them by the school. This leads us to the remarkable greed at the core of the NCAA values. Simply put, college athletes don't get paid a penny. The NCAA treats players as amateurs and won't allow them to make money off their image, their name, or their likeness. Universities make millions a year off the blood, sweat, and tears of its athletes, and in return pay for the athlete's education. An education that doesn't even come close to how much the athletes earn their schools. Of course, universities need money to pay for facilities and programs and scholarships. However, it can be argued if they can afford to pay for all these things, then they can afford to play the players. All it requires is proper allocation of revenue. In the 2018-2019 season, the top 20 university earners made more than $125 million each. Gonzaga reported $12 million in revenue in 2016, which has only increased in the following years. This clear exploitation of labor is unacceptable and even starts prior to college. A violation of NCAA rules in high school may prevent a student from even having the opportunity to be recruited. How is it that an organization that heavily regulates student financial engagement can't be bothered to regulate the conduct of team administrators, staff, as well as the players themselves? How is it that an organization values monetary gain or the very lives of the athletes that do all the heavy lifting? All important questions, and all you need to remember is the NCAA at its heart is a greed-driven organization led at best negligent businessmen with one motive. Either way you look at it, things need to be changed. To get a better understanding of the issues at hand, I highly recommend the videos linked in the description below.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Complete the quiz below to win the prize shown here, and have a great day.